So being a pastor is tougher than you think, but everything comes on the desk of the pastor. Pray for your pastor. It's very easy to criticize a pastor, the leader of your local church. When you don't agree with anything, he is to blame, or she, it's her fault. He is to blame. When you don't agree with some decision, it's his fault. He is to blame. When I became a pastor, I realized, I felt what it is to be a pastor. The pressure on you is tremendous. Spiritually, mentally, socially, people expecting you to do this, to do many things. When they don't solve anything or they cannot solve it, they put it on your plate. And you have to solve it in their way, how they want to do it. Well, if you want to do it yourself, do it yourself. Don't give it to your pastor. But everything comes on the desk of the pastor, and he has to solve it. And as a pastor, you hear a lot of gossip. Sometimes vicious, evil gossip. People come and tell you, do you know about this sister or this brother? Why don't you go and pray for this person? Search your heart. Cleanse your heart. Don't come to your pastor with a lot of vicious gospel. Why? Why are you telling him those things? First pray, and if it's really something, then go to him. But first pray, and don't just gossip because you have to gossip. His ears are not a garbage can. So being a pastor is tougher than you think. It's much, much tougher and heavier than you think. Now, a pastor cannot tell you everything. He cannot explain every decision. He knows a lot of things that are confidential because people are talking to him, but also things that the Lord tells him. He cannot tell you everything. You cannot even understand it. And he's not accountable to you in the first place. In the first place, he is accountable to the Lord Jesus, to God himself. He has to talk to God. And if you don't agree with anything, go on your knees and pray, because many things you cannot understand because he cannot clearly explain it to you. Being a pastor can be a burden. It can be very lonesome, but it's also very rewarding, because by the grace of God, you can be part of people's life. You can see the hand of God working in the church, in the city, in people's life. So give your pastor what he deserves, the peace, the grace, the love, the strength that you want to receive yourself. Give it also to him or her. And I want to pray now for all the pastors, that you will be faithful, that you receive the love of God, the grace of God, the wisdom of God, the strength of God. And I'll also pray for protection over your life and your family, because many lives of pastors and their families are attacked by the demonic. And I pray the blood of Jesus over this family of you, my pastor, that you will be faithful, that you will not give up, you will not stop, you will not quit, but that you will get the strength of God, and that you will continue to do faithfully the work of God. I pray this for you and your family in Jesus' name. So you, member of the church, have some patience with your pastor. Pray for him, show him some love, don't gossip. First go on your knees, pray for him and the church, because if he is prospering, you too will prosper. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.